Today we're going to index the barrel on my Skout. First though, I want to thank everyone that's bought Skout products through my affiliate link. About 5 or 6 people have bought guns now through my affiliate links, and that's really huge because they give me a 10% commission. So thank you, and there will be a link in the description of this video or any of my Skout videos where you can shop Skout direct. The new Skouts have this super tricky indexing system. You just loosen up your barrel, spin it to the next number, and today I'll walk you through the process of how and why we index our barrels. The short version is that every barrel has a crown or a slight bend to it. So if you line that perfectly up, then your bullets are going to fall straight down, let's say between 50 and 100 yards. If you're sighted in at 50 yards and your barrel is not indexed, then at 100 yards, your point of impact will probably not be straight down. It may be to the right or to the left. Now, if I sighted in at 100 yards, that would make no difference. Look at my velocity. But if you want to be able to stack pellet on pellet at 50 yards, and then whip your gun out and shoot a can at 300 yards,
oh, booyah,
then you might want to index your barrel. Now, here we go. There are probably more air gun models than firearms models that you can index the barrel on. So the Impact is one of them. The Leshy is another. But of course, the Skout system has to be the easiest.
Dude, did you just see that?
As well, spoiler alert, we ended up at 8.7.
All right, well, I just got rich.
And 2.7. So having these marks at all 12 points on your barrel is very helpful when you're trying to get it perfect.
All right, so this is our bullseye. So at the 12 o'clock position, we're going to hit right here because that's where we're zeroed at. So this is going to be 12. And then, or let's just say 3 o'clock position might hit right here. So that's going to say 3. And then the 6 o'clock position might hit right here. These are just random points. And then the 9 o'clock position might hit right here. And then you guys, this is corresponding to a clock. So the position of my barrel when it's at 12 o'clock, it's hitting here because that's where I'm zeroed at. When I move the barrel to 3 o'clock, it's hitting here. When I move it to 6 o'clock, it's hitting here. 9 o'clock, it's hitting here. So we see that the 3 o'clock and the 6 o'clock are the top and bottom positions. However, they're not lined up perfectly. So what we'd want to do is turn it back a little bit and get the top and bottom so they're lined up perfectly. And that's pretty much it. So that's where we're going to use the numbers that are between. And fortunately, all 12 points are marked on our Skout barrel.
And when I say we want the two groups lined up, I mean we want them lined up vertically, perfectly, one right on top of the other. We'll go ahead and start off on this one. I'm going to do 3 shots. By the way, this hole right here was when I was sighting in and I bumped the trigger without even aiming.
Obviously, we're not sighted in perfectly, but that's not going to matter.
All right, see what happens. 3 o'clock position. The other thing to note is that these are not typical 50-yard Skout group. I just put an updated valve in my gun, and I haven't tuned it yet. Now we are going to 6. Definitely our 6 o'clock group right there. All right, finally we are at 9 o'clock.
All right, let's just get this up close here. Okay, right here we got my 12, my 0 position. That one was 3. This was 6. And this was the final one at 9. So we can tell that our top and bottom is 9 and 3. So I would like this to come over this way a little bit and this to come over this way a little bit. So I am going to try 8 and 2. And we'll see if those two line up perfectly straight up and down. All right, I'm gonna turn this now to a nice, healthy 8 right there. All right, now we're gonna go to 2 o'clock and see what happens. We still got a teeny ways to go.
Next, I rotated my barrel just a little bit more the same direction so that my two positions were 8.5 and 2.5.
Oh, I slipped on that one, but you can see that we were 99% there. That's why I went ahead and ended up going to 8.7 and 2.7. And I'm not showing it in the video, but I was perfectly lined up. The last little bit of information is that now that you have two positions, you can pick either one. If you pick the top group, your crown will be facing down with your pellet shooting up slightly. If you choose the bottom group, it's going to be in the opposite position. But in either case, your ammo is going to drop straight down at longer distances. All right, everybody, that's it for me on this one. There'll be a link in the description if you need any Skout products from Skout Direct or Pyramid Air. But till next week, happy shooting. We'll see you on the next one.